human and economic resources. The world is changing very rapidly, and new political and economic alliances are being made on various countries and regions to reap the benefits of globalization for a secure and sustainable growth and development. There is so much currently happening in terms of economic development both in Pakistan and in its surrounding regions, despite the difficult geopolitical situations. Due to its geographical position, Pakistan is very well placed to act as a catalyst for economic growth and prosperity for the whole of South and Central Asia and the Middle East. After the signing and initiation of the China-Pakistan Economic Corridor and inking of multilateral agreements for supply of energy and gas between different countries of the region using Pakistan as a central point, the dynamics of economic development and progress in the South Asian region is fast changing. The successful execution and implementation of these initiatives and projects will produce abundance of opportunities in all spheres of life, businesses and economy. These would also prove to be a game changer for the well-being, peace and prosperity of the people of Pakistan and its surrounding countries and regions. Here I would like to share with you a message of October 22, 2010 from the Chairman, International Auditing and Assurance Board, Professor Adil Schiller, who came to Pakistan the very first time as a guest of ICAP. I would like to share with you a few important lines from his message, and I quote, "Dear friends, once more I would like to thank you and James Schiller, Executive Director IFAC, joined me for the wonderful days in Pakistan. We enjoyed the many public and private meetings. We learned a lot about your impressive country and had great fun as well. In the plane to Dubai, I read the Financial Times London of October 21st, an article titled, Pakistan, the state that refused to fail. It concludes, if Pakistan can survive a year like this, it can survive anything. This is precisely what we learned from the speech of your chief guest and the whole of our vision," unquote. The said article in the Financial Times, which is still available on the internet, had highlighted various natural and unnatural turmoils and catastrophes being faced by Pakistan, whether it be the earthquakes, floods, wars on the neighboring borders, numerous terrorist attacks, displacement of people, weak economy, crisis of governance and whatnot, and at the same time, the resilience of our nation to fight back and survive in such conditions. The punchlines of the conclusion of this article were, and I quote, "The world is rightly alarmed at the mayhem that rages at its center. But if you care to look on the bright side, you might conclude that if Pakistan survives a year like this, it can survive anything," unquote. With the blessing of Allah Almighty, time has proved that our great nation is fully determined to survive forever and has fought back vigorously throughout these crises for successfully overcoming all the difficulties and challenges one by one towards the journey of success and sustainability. Ladies and gentlemen, it is our resolve not to give up and surrender against all the obstacles, and we as a nation have tremendous capacity to face, handle, survive, grow and smile in any difficult situation and move on. And this will always remain so with the blessing of Almighty. All the shining faces sitting in this wonderful event are the reflection of the resilience of the people of Pakistan, a country that is not afraid of any pessimism or turmoil. We as a responsible nation are fully geared up to fulfill our responsibilities for capitalizing on all the emerging opportunities towards the peace and prosperity of the people of Pakistan and the entire region. The accounting profession all across the region are very well placed, being at the helm of affairs both in the private and public sectors. Therefore, they can play a major role in the economic development of the respective countries by capitalizing on the huge opportunities that are emerging all around the South Asian region. Since its inception in 1984, The SAFA Forum has been carrying out its professional activities without the influence of any political issues or intervention. ICAB, being the founding member of SAFA and having the honor of hosting its very first assembly meeting in 1985, has always played a major role in the development and growth of the profession within the region. I would also like to congratulate my brother colleague Naeem Akhtar Sheikh for being elected as President SAFA for 2016. I hope that this regional forum will achieve many more milestones under his able leadership during 2016. I appreciate the efforts of our organizing committee for arranging a galaxy of very renowned and competent speakers who would be sharing their valuable thoughts and experiences on a variety of important topics in different sessions of the conference. I am very confident that these sessions will provide some great knowledge base as well as unique opportunity to expand your professional horizons with many new ideas to be implemented in your respective jurisdictions towards improvements in the economy and the profession. I also hope that ICAB SAFA Conference 2016 will not only focus on the ways to bring effective and sustainable development in the region, but also address the future needs and issues that should lead to the development of the economy within the region and the world at large. I extend my best wishes to all the participants and speakers and look forward to a useful and meaningful exchange of views at the conference. I would also like to thank our sponsors for their generous support, without which this conference would not have been possible. I once again thank you all for your presence and participation in the conference. Thank you once again, and Pakistan Zindabad.
Thank you very much indeed to the President of ICAB for those encouraging words. And as you've just heard, this year the Institute of Chartered Accountants of Pakistan has brought home the privilege of hosting the SAFA Annual Conference 2016. And the theme of this conference is South Asia Corridor of Opportunities. Now, to share his valuable thoughts on this theme, I'm delighted to invite our next guest. He is, as you've heard, President of the South Asian Federation of Accountants and past President of ICAP in the term 2013-2014. Please give a warm welcome to the President of SAFA, Mr. Naeem Akhtar Sheikh.
His Excellency Malik Muhammad Rafiq Ridwana, Governor of Punjab, Professor Dr. Hassan Iqbal, our keynote speaker today, the Honorable Minister for Planning, Development and Reforms, Hafiz Muhammad Yusuf, the President of the Institute of Chartered Accountants of Pakistan, Mr. Manoj Fitness, the President of the Institute of Chartered Accountants of India, Mr. Arjun Aher, the immediate past president of South Asian Federation of Accountants, Mr. A.S. Rahmani, the vice president of South Asian Federation of Accountants, Mr. Lasantha Vakramasinghe, the president of the Institute of Chartered Accountants of Sri Lanka, delegates from SAFA, the honorable past presidents, the honorable council member, regional committee members, the honorable seniors, and honorable members of the Institute of Chartered Accountants of Pakistan, ladies and gentlemen, a very good evening and assalamu alaikum. It's indeed a great privilege and pleasure for me to address this August gathering. The SAFA stewardship has come to our institute after a pause of 8 years, and we are really fortunate that we are graced by the presence of the Honorable Governor at this auspicious event. Thank you, Mr. Governor. The South Asian Federation of Accountants is an apex body of SAFA with more than 300,000 membership and about 2 million students. This body was created in August 1984 by 7 bodies of the SAFA by signing a constitution in New Delhi. The body was set up with the aim of positioning, maintaining and developing the accounting profession in South Asia and also ensuring its eminence in the world of accounting and also to act in public interest for the socio-economic